Matt Wallace, should I sell my Dogecoin now and buy back in at 0.09? No, absolutely not. That's like saying, imagine you have a ticket to the moon in your head and you know the rocket's about to take off at some point. You don't know exactly what day it's going to take off, but you know that rocket dang sure is going to take the heck off. Then you say, huh, I wonder if I should sell my ticket to the moon right now and then try to buy back that same ticket after the price is potentially lower at some point in the future. And you don't know when the rocket's going to go off, right? So then you sell the ticket, and the dude who bought the ticket's like, oh, wow, we're going to the moon. The moon landing's announced. Then we see this, and then boom, all of a sudden the rocket takes off, and you're sitting there. You don't have a ticket to the moon. You could have been sitting there on the moon jumping around in your spacesuit, but instead you're sitting at home in your PJs eating a PB&J while watching reruns of The Office and wondering why Dwight was not able to think of more clever pranks against Jim, considering the fact that he is in fact a mastermind of sorts. You have to wonder, surely he could have thought of at least a couple better pranks to get Jim. It was relatively one-sided, wasn't it? I'm disappointed in you, Dwight. You could have done better. But that's the point. And so no, is it a good idea to sell Dogecoin? Absolutely not, because you're not going to want to even take that chance, even though we know there is a possibility that is higher than we would like, that it could fall to that level of around 9 cents. We know it's not going to fall further than that by any degree that will last whatsoever. And we also know that when it does spike, it's going to be so worth it to hold it that a lot of people are going to try to buy in and buy in at way higher prices, and that's what's going to cause the spike. So it's really about gives and takes here. Yes, there's risk associated. If you're in a position where you need the money now, like let's say, for example, you have a cat that you just rescued from the side of I-85, and that cat really badly needs milk right now, and you can't afford milk for the cat. Well, then you can go and sell some of your Dogecoin and buy milk for the cat. But if you're not in that specific situation, I find it hard to imagine any really real scenario where it would make sense to get rid of your moon ticket and plan to buy it back and then potentially miss the ride altogether. Especially if you've been holding for a while and believing for a while, that's just, it would, think about what it would do to your mental levels if you miss the moon landing with Dogecoin and the big rocket off because you sold and tried to buy back in. Think about that. Just your mental standing alone is not worth that. Is it worth it? Absolutely not. If it falls 20%, your mental standing will be like, okay, yeah, I can handle that. I mean, yeah, it's not fun to watch it fall. But if your mental standing is in a position where it's watching on the sidelines while Dogecoin goes crazy, I mean, how can you recover from that? It's over. You'll never be able to smile again unless you use a specific surgery that makes a smile appear on your face, which I wouldn't recommend because that sounds very painful. But anyway, I'm Matt Wallace. Make sure to subscribe with the notifications on. This is Final Stand, and I will see you in the next video.